Hello, this is Adolf. Welcome to the video lecture series on the course of building construction. So we already covered the stone masonry topic under the unit number 3. So by this video, we are going to start the second topic in the unit number 3, that is brick masonry. So brick masonry is a little bit big topic, so we will see in part by part videos. So in this video we are going to see about the introduction to the brick masonry and what are the terms that are related to the brick masonry. So these two topics only we are going to see in this video lecture. Let's start our video lecture by the topic introduction to the brick masonry. So brick masonry is a unified mass. So unified mass means it has become united, or it is act as a one, or it will act as a one. So brick masonry is a unified mass obtained by systematic arrangement of laying brick, systematic arrangement of laying brick, and it is bonded together with the help of mortar. This brick, so in the brick masonry we will use a brick. So brick is a building unit of hard inorganic clay material of size which can be conveniently we can handle it. So this is a brick. So the brick masonry, where we use the brick masonry? So the brick masonry is used in foundation, is used in foundation, walls we will use, columns we will use, window sills, so many structures, window sill or a retaining structure, fireplace, fumes, tall chimneys, gravity walls, culverts, step floors, arches, where that we can use a brick masonry. The strength of brick masonry work depends upon the quality of brick and type of mortar used. So what which quality of brick we are using and what type of mortar we are using, by these two the strength of the brick masonry depends on. So generally mortars are following types used for brick masonry. So first one is mud mortar. So mud mortar is in this mud will use as a binder. So in this mud will be used as a binder, and sawdust, rice husk or cow dung, it will be used as a fine aggregate. So this is the mud mortar. Second is cement mortar. So in cement mortar we know cement will use as a binding material, and the sand will be used as a aggregate. And third is cement lime mortar. So cement lime mortar is nothing but cement and the lime together, it will be used as a binding material, whereas sand will be used as a aggregate. So cement and lime will be used in appropriate ratios. Fourth is lime surki mortar. Same as cement lime, here lime surki will be act as a binding material, and lime will act as a binding material and surki will be act as a aggregate. So these are the mortars who are used in brick masonry. So what are the terms that are used in brick masonry? The first term is structure. So see the diagram of the brick. See the diagram of the brick. So we have three. One is structure, another one is head, another one is bed. So structure, when we call it as a structure, means when your bricks are laid with its length parallel to face. So for a brick, this area is length, this one is breadth. So if your bricks are laid with its length parallel to face or direction of the wall, we will call it as a structure. If the same brick is laid with its breadth parallel to the face or direction of the wall, so breadth parallel to the face or direction of the wall, we will call it as a header. So structure means length parallel to the face of the wall, header means breadth parallel to the face of the wall. And the third one is bed. So bed is the, this is the surface, the brick. So it is a top surface, and bottom also we will have this type of surface. So bed is the bottom surface of the brick. So structure is length parallel to the face, header is with breadth parallel to the face, bed is the bottom surface of the brick. The fourth one is course. So course is the horizontal layer of brick or stone is known as course. So not a vertical. So in this diagram, see, this is a one course layer of brick or stone, and this one is another course. So these are the courses, horizontal layer. So the horizontal layer, these are all the course, horizontal layer of brick or stone, we'll call it as a course. So then there's a structure course means, so all the bricks in the course are laid length parallel to the face of the wall. So are laid as a structure. Structure means length parallel to the face of the wall. So structure course means all bricks are laid length parallel to the face of the wall. Header course means all bricks are laid breadth parallel to the course of the wall. So course is the horizontal layer of a brick or stone. So in a course, if you are using length parallel to the face of the wall, we will call it as a structure course. And if your breadth, it is parallel to the face of the wall, we will call it as a header course. So this is structure course. And here it is header course. So these are the courses. Next is facing. So facing, we already know, the surface of the wall exposed to the weather, and the material used in the face of the wall, we will call it as the facing. So in this diagram, so these are the faces of the wall, these areas and all faces of the wall, and backing will be in the other side. So surface not exposed to weather, we will call it as a backing. So hotting is the position, the interlock position between facing and backing. So this area we will call it as the hotting. So facing exposed to weather, backing not exposed to weather, hotting is the portion between facing and backing. Tenth one is join. The point of two or more brick or stone is called as joint. So joints consist of cement or lime mortar. So according to the joints, if it is in horizontal, we will call it as a bed joint. So bed joint is the horizontal layer of mortar upon which bricks are laid. So if this is one brick and we are applying a mortar over the brick number one, and we are placing the brick number two over that, so the joint between these two bricks that marked in red line, it is called bed joint. So this is the bed joint. So head joint is the, as given in the diagram, given in the figure, we can understand what is a head joint. Up Perpends. 12th one is perpends. Perpends is the vertical joint of mortar which separates bricks and stones is known as perpends. So this perpends is for good bonding. So see in the diagram here, it is marked in red. So these are the perpends. It is the vertical joint or mortar which separates the two bricks. So that is called perpends. Arrasures. Arrasures is the edge formed by the intersection of the edge formed by the intersection of plane surface of a brick. So formed by the intersection of plane surface of a brick. In a good brick, it is sharp and straight. So arrasures in the brick is, so this is one plane and this one is another plane. By this intersecting, we will have a one edge. This is the edge. So this edge should be sharp and it should be straight. That is called arrase. So 14th one is lap. So lap is the horizontal distance between the vertical joints in successive courses. So for a good bond, it should be 1/4 of the length of the brick. So this is one vertical joint and this is one another vertical joint, and between these distance or it was horizontal distance, we will call it as a lap. Next is closure. So a piece of brick which is used to prevent the joints of successive courses to come in a vertical line. So it is a piece of a brick which is to prevent the courses to be in successive vertical lines. So if you take this is one vertical joint line and we won't be giving here another one vertical joint line. So to avoid that one, we will use the closure. So see in this second diagram. So there are closure is provided here. Quint closure. So this is one type of closure. So why? Because to avoid this vertical joint in order. So we are giving one small closure. So if this closure is not there, what will happen? Every joint will be come in straight line. So to avoid that purpose only, we are giving the closure. So this is the header course, this is the structure course, and this is the quin course. So that from the diagram you can understand it. There are different types of closure. So first one is quin closure. So quin closure is obtained by cutting a brick along its length. So cutting a brick along its length. It is to minimize the wastage of brick. So this is how our closure, a quin closure will be look like. So we are cutting the brick along its length. Length we are cutting. That is quin closure. King closure is obtained by cutting half header, half structure. So here it is half header, half is gone, here half structure is gone. So this type of closure is called king closure. Third one is beveled closure. So beveled closure is obtained by cutting in triangular form, but in beveled closure, what will take half width of the header from one side and full length of the structure in one side. So we will cut in half width and the full width on the structure in one side, and we will keep the other ends full width of the structure as well as full width of the header and full width of the structure will be kept in untouched. So beveled head means half width of the structure and the full width of the, say half width of the header and the full width of the structure will be cut at one end, and the other end we will keep the full width of the structure and full width of the header. That is beveled closure. Next is method closure. So the method closure is obtained by cutting a triangular portion of the bit through its width. So in the bevel we cut structure full length, but in method we cut header full width, but structure we won't go for the full length. The angle between the angle, the making an angle with the length is 45 degree to 60 degree. Up to 45 degree to 60 degree we will cut the portion. That is method closure. Next one is BAT. So BAT is the when the portion of brick is cut through the width. So if you are cutting the brick through its width is known as BAT. And this BAT is also used as a closure. Closing for closure we will use this BAT also. It is divided in different types: half BAT, three quarter BAT and beveled BAT. Half BAT means it will cut the brick off from three quarter means three quarter kept in the brick and one quarter will be cut off from the brick, that is three quarter BAT. And beveled means it is from the three quarter we will make an angle, that is beveled BAT. Bullnose is the bricks whose edges are round in shape. So rounded in shape is known as bullnose. Seen in the diagram, the edges are round in shape. It is used for rounded pion. So any rounded pion is a rounded corner is there, we will use this bullnose brick. There are two types of bullnose. One is single bullnose and double bullnose. Next is frog. So frog is a small depression created purposely on one side of the brick. So in the brick bed is the bottom layer. So in the bottom surface, the upper surface, we have a small depression. Purposefully, we created that depression on the one side of the brick. That is called frog. So why we are giving the frog means for holding the mortar and good bond between the brick. So for holding the mortar and good bond between brick, we will give the frog to the brick. Bond. So bond is the method of arranging a brick in a course. So how we are going to arrange a brick in a course? It is a header wise or it is a structure wise or a combination of header or a structure. So how we are going to arrange a brick in a course, we will call it as a bond. 20th is pion. So pion, we already know it is a cornerstone, the intersecting walls, the two intersecting walls, we will provide a pion. So on the face side of the wall at a corner, pion is used. We also call it as a cornerstone. Next is toothing. So toothing is the termination of the wall in such a fashion that, or in a such a way that each alternate course at the end projects. So we will cut the wall. So each alternative, here we cut, here we cut. So this each alternative cutting course is called as toothing. So it is adapted to provide adequate bond when the wall is continued horizontally at a later stage. So if you are constructed this wall, so under later, after years, if you want to construct a wall to be continued, or after some later stage, you have to continue the wall. So that from the toothing, they will construct the wall structure. So this toothing will provide an adequate bonding bond to the continuing wall. So this is the toothing. So in this video we covered the introduction to the brick masonry and what are the terms that we are going to use in the brick masonry we saw in this video. Thank you.